So this is Pete Burns of Dead or Alive, and this is our new album, Mad, Bad and Dangerous to Know. Musically, everybody has a hand in writing the songs. When it comes down to choruses, catchphrases, it's usually down to just me, because I find it very hard to interpret anybody else's idea of what I should be singing. If you only knew, I have no idea at all, and no idea at all of what I do. And that is why, productively, we only work in spurts. We're not a very prolific band. We'll write 20 songs and we'll throw away 10 of them. And we have a very tough process of what is approved. It's got to be memorable, as far as I'm concerned, not just for a financial thing. The longer I've been in the music industry, the more I realise performers and things get more and more pretentious and try and become really arty. And by that process, you're alienating your audience. It's just pretense and brushing your own ego, really, so we try and keep things really simple. The more complicated a song becomes, the more likely it is to be thrown in the bin. I think the only thing that gives me ideas to write about, or to say ad-lib lyrics about, is the fact that I've listened to a lot of pop music over the years, right back from when I was a child. I've listened to records like the Everly Brothers, right up until the success of people like Blondie with records like Denis Denis. And those things always really inspired me, because they were so simple and almost childish, you know. That's the only inspiration that I have from the pop music that I've heard over the years. You know, I'd never want to write about anything political, because I don't think it's really fair to put your complaints to music. People just don't want to hear it, you know. Without being too derogatory about our own music, I just want to write things that people just don't have to analyse. What you hear is exactly what it is. It's just so simple and on the surface. Every album's a progression. We hope to progress with every album. Looking in retrospect at our records, there's nothing that we've done that I ever feel ashamed of or bad about. I think everything stood perfectly as a marker of its time in the dance music field. I think our first album, Sophisticated Boom Boom, very sadly was very underrated, because when you look at the commercial potential of that album in comparison to British bands like New Order, who have a very good sound, I think we did it a lot better. But because of the field we were in and trying to establish ourselves as that kind of group, it was very hard to break that album. Second album, Youthquake, was just a progression for us as songwriters. And we were in a very strange period when we did Youthquake. We'd had a major upheaval with management. We changed managers, and I think the record company was starting to worry and probably lose faith as to our commercial potential. So Youthquake was an LP that really had to be successful. And the more people made us aware that our album had to be commercial and really successful, the more we just switched off and did what we wanted, and it came out very commercial. It was very successful. This album, the album Mad, Bad and Dangerous to Know, I feel that the songs are much better crafted as songs that could be adapted to any style. And sadly, the thing is about us doing the kind of hard dance music we do, the songwriting is very underrated. Nobody actually spots the songs, but you could play those songs on an acoustic guitar or a piano. But every album I hope to be a progression. I don't think this is the definitive Dead or Alive album. I don't think it's the best thing that we've done. I think that when we do the definitive album, we'll probably retire. The song Hooked on Love, as with all the songs, as I've said before, has got no particular theme. It was just a catchy phrase at the time. It's got no particular relevance or meaning. It's awfully dull to explain our songs like this, but it's just a pop song.
What I'm feeling is like a party here, and I would feel
that's Hooked on Love from our